Hello all, welcome to Lee Technologies. In today's session, we'll discuss about AOL module of Oracle eBusiness Suite. Let's get into outline. This is a basic session on AOL. We'll try to understand what is AOL, what are the components which we consider them as AOL, and the tables. And what is the purpose? I mean, usages in the real-time world, as well as, you know, like what are the tools required, if at all, let us say if you want to learn AOL module of eBusiness Suite, what is the thing you have to understand? What are the tools required for that? So one basic thing is Oracle eBusiness Suite is a ERP application, which will have a lot number of modules, around 150 plus modules. So each module will have its set of functionality, nothing but let us say if we consider financial general ledger, it is for the purpose of general ledger purpose. If it is AR, it is for account receivable purpose. If it is AP, account payable purpose. So each module will have its set of particular process and a functionality. In the same way, we have the basic module called AOL, Application Object Library. It is also a foundation module, nothing but every module requires this Application Object Library requirement. Nothing but let us say if you are booking a purchase order, you'll have a purchase order type. So that information comes from AOL module, nothing but it uses set of components from the AOL. So not to deviate, now the basic thing is let us understand AOL is the foundation module in Oracle eBusiness Suite. So let us say if your customer is a manufacturing client and if he is purchasing a SCM license, obviously require AOL by default. I mean, AOL is included by default. So any client, whatever the module they use it, AOL by default will come with a license. Okay. So that's the reason it is called FND module or foundation module. So the application short name is FND and the module name is Application Object Library module. Okay. And what are the components which generally comes under part of this one? What are the components? So we have to have a clarity on the module and components. So module is nothing but, you know, like now Oracle ERP is a big suite of software. That particular software is divided into set of modules. So the major modules are generally like a financials, HRMS, general payables, PPM, CRM, right? And the same way, AOL is a foundation module. It doesn't serve any business purpose, nothing but for a client. It is not directly required for his business, but it is indirectly required for the eBusiness Suite application itself to run. Without this module, your eBusiness Suite application will not even work. Okay, so that's the reason this is the one of the very important module, even for a functional or technical person, have to have a clarity on this, which will ease their understanding of application. Okay, so let me repeat. So the set of components which comes under part of AOL are like users, responsibilities, menus, functions, concurrent program, lookups, value set, flexi field, request group, messages, and many more are there. I've not listed the total stuff, but majority of the components I listed here. And here the screen, the particular right side, the picture which you are seeing here, this is the FND top location of the AOL. So the module name is Application Object Library, and this particular screenshot is my server screenshot of the FND top location. Okay. Now, so as a user or a developer, if you want to find out like some information about your generally, like, you know, you can also validate what are the modules which are installed for your particular eBusiness Suite. So you can just go to application developer. So in most of the screens, like I have provided a screenshot, just like navigation wise, just try to understand what are the things which is highlighted in a gray color. That's a navigation. So here I'm in the application developer responsibility navigation. Within the application menu, click on register and you can search with the list of application. Here I wantedly highlighted the application object library by searching with the application short name. If you want to find out which modules are installed, you can try to use this particular two tables. One is FND application TL table and FND application table. Okay, you can join with them and you can get the appropriate short name as well as a top location. In most of the times what happens is like you may have a different name for your application name. The short name will be a different one. Here in our AOL sense, that is how it is. The application name is Application Object Library, but the application short name is FND, right? So don't assume by default your short name as well as application name. You can easily try to make a, what you say, convention from that. It's not possible. Okay. So one more thing you have to understand is like any table in Oracle eBusiness Suite, if it starts with FND underscore, it is part of AOL. Okay. That's another clarity you have to get it. Now let's get into some of the components. Now let us say, like, as I told you, like, I was trying, like, in this is a basic session on the AOL. So we'll try to just show you some of the AOL components, how we define, where are they used, and what are the tables involved for that. Okay, in one of this AOL components, one is like a lookup. So if you just observe here, the look, when you want to define a lookup, first of all, navigate to application developer, and in this, get into lookups. In this lookups, again, you have a lot number of things. You can go with this one, the first one, application object library, click on that. And here application, like here, if you observe, right, these are the things which I mentioned. This lookup, actually what I have done is like in this particular lookup, I just mentioned the list of ERP applications in the market. Okay, this is my lookup type, lookup meaning. And what is application? So here I mentioned application object library, but in normal, in real time scenarios, what we do is whenever any customer installs Oracle eBusiness Suite for them, they will also have a custom application defined for them. And all those things, so for that, what we have to do is we have to mention the custom application. So what do you mean by custom application? So we know that by default, when a customer buys Oracle eBusiness Suite, it will provide a set of modules based on the customer license. But what we do is whatever the components which we define from the scratch as a developer, when you define something from scratch according to the requirements, what we do is we call it them as custom objects, and they have to be defined in a custom application so that you can validate which are provided by Oracle and which are defined by, which are defined or which are created by developer for the customer purpose. Okay, that's generally, that's the reason we call them as custom objects. So in the application, always just try to mention the your custom application, whichever you define in your real-time environment. If you want to find out from database, you know, like whatever you define, whatever you create in the Oracle, this particular forms, everything will get recorded in the database table, right? So this is a table, FNA lookup values is a table, and just mention the lookup name and you'll get the list of values. Okay, so generally lookups are used in the PLSQL programs, reports, forms, OAF pages, workflow. Okay, now let's get into another slide. AOL components, other one is messages. This is one of the very important thing. So whenever you get any confirmation, error, warning, right, all these things are part of AOL components. We generally, what we do is we never try to hard code the message content. The reason is, let us say you may want to modify the message name, message value, or you want to include parameters in that, right? That's the reason generally never hard code your message content. Just hard code your message name so that you can always modify your message text. So the table name in which we store the, which the particular message gets stored is FNA new messages table. So here if you observe, right, so these, all the things are provided by, provided for AOL module, and these are used in most of the other applications. So that's the reason it's called foundation module. Value set. So navigation I provided here, just click on, you know, like application developer in the validation and set and value. So creating a value set is a two-step process. First of all, you have to click on set, and here you have to mention the value set name and what is the maximum size for a particular column value. And here validation type I just selected independent. In the value set, we have a lot number of value set types, but here I just included only value set type independent, validation type independent. And where exactly it is used? It is used in PLSQL, reports, forms, OAF pages, workflow, and especially in concurrent programs parameter. Whenever you have any concurrent program, if you want to have a parameter, the only option you have is a value set. Okay, you can also use lookup, but in like you require indirect way of getting the value from the lookup. Nothing but you have to create a query and from there you can assign to value set. That's how you can do it. And how do you define a value? Just click on the value form, and here you can mention the list of values and their description. And if you want to get the list of information from the backend, try to observe these particular tables. There are three tables involved here. The first one is FNA flex value sets, which will have the value set name, and FNA flex values, which will have the value set values. And here we have one more table called TL, where you will have a description of the code. The reason is, like generally, like some of the tables supports translation feature, in which the value, like for each language, you can define your own value so that based on the user selected language, the value will be displayed accordingly. Okay. Now the thing is, like how do we create a user, right? So if you want to create a user in the Oracle eBusiness Suite, you require system administrator navigation. Go to system administrator. There, you select the security menu, then user, then define. And in that, you just create this, but like I just create a username, and you mention the list of responsibilities which are required. So for any technical developer, always you require this set of responsibilities. Okay, application developer, system administrator, system administration, XML publisher administrator, as well as workflow administrator. And here I assigned a person here, nothing but like, let us say if you are working some set of modules, you require this particular user is linked to a person, then only it will work according to the process which is defined in that particular module. Okay, now this is a table. FND user is a table in which you'll have the information about the users which are created. See, there is a different fine difference between the employee in HRMS and the user in the e-business suite. User are the like the end users who work on the business application for the business purposes. Okay, now how do you migrate, right? So how do you migrate this particular AOL components from one instance to another instance? We have a utility called FND load. So FND load is a program, I mean to say. FND load is a program which we use for the purpose of migrating all the AOL components. Okay, FND load generally will have these four important things. One is loader data file, loader control file, download command, and upload command. Loader data file will have the information about for which component you are, the component information, nothing but let us say if you're downloading a lookup, right? So this LDT file of the lookup will have all the contents which you define in your lookup. LCT file, for each particular component, Oracle provides a LCT file. Okay, now when you perform downloads using FND load download command, what happens is it will download the LDT file, and this will have the content of your AOL component. And if you want to upload command is used to upload the data which you provided in your LDT file. Okay, I'm not getting much deeper into the AOL components. I'll try to provide another session on the AOL, which will have more clarity on, you know, like next coming things of the AOL. So the developer tools which you require for the other session on the AOL will be like you require any of the eBusiness Suite version. It can be 12.1.3 or 12.2 start, and Notepad++ is very much required. WinSCP and PuTTY, and also you require some set of Unix basics. It is not mandatory, but having knowledge on Unix is much you know like much beneficial for a developer. Okay. Please do subscribe to my channel. Please do provide your valuable comments. Thank you.